Hey guys, how's it going? Haggard Nerd here, playing some ASTRONEER. And in this episode, we are going to take our awesome, I don't know, rover train out into the world and see what we can find. Oh man, the game's got so much better once I got this rover. I have so much more space and so much more battery power to store and to be productive with. Instead of having to run back and forth, my backpack gets all loaded up. I have run out of power, have to deal with tethers. This thing now deals with my air. Like, I can just go back to the truck and refresh my O2 and my battery. Here's some resin. You know what? We have space. We're gonna dig it up because we can. Oh, this is so great. And I will admit, I have a bit of a fondness for vehicles and games. Don't know why, I just do. Okay, so one thing I did learn is you have to be connected via the power line in order to pull in power from the vehicles. I mean, say you have no power, but really your suit has no power, however the vehicles you're connected to do have power. Alright, looks like we are good on resin here. Let's go put them up in their areas. Not that they have areas to reside. I didn't put it on that side. Hey. There we go. This is so good. Okay. Alright, I'm going to try to kind of fill this in a little bit so that way when I drive past it, I don't fall in. Not quite grasped this just yet. It's fine. It's good. Now the question is, am I gonna still be able to see home? Oh wow, that was a big planet. Can't wait until I can check out other planets. I think I was here before. Yeah, this is where I was when I found those other technologies. I'm worried I'm going to get myself stuck. We're going to go through this valley here. See what's on the other side. Because we can. Oh, that's so beautiful. And what do we have here? Oh, man. That's fantastic. So we just found some compound and then another crashed ship. So we are definitely starting this off good. So much compound. No complaints. Yeah, I'm glad I saw that. Okay. I think I'm going to load this evenly. I don't know if it has any effect on the actual weight and balance, but I'm going to do this just in case. And we'll just have to find some more compound and put it on the other side too. Oh look, more compound. There's some resin down there too. Now this, I've noticed this is a very large patch of compound. This is probably the largest patch of compound I've ever found. Now, one of a couple things is going on here. Either one, I just happen to get lucky and find a very, very large patch of compound, or B, or two, I don't know what I said. It's getting late. There's some sort of algorithm that says the further away from your home base, the more, rich the vein is. I played a lot of Factorio too. I don't know if you guys have ever heard that game, but there was a mod that allowed for that to happen. Like, the further away from your home base you get, the more, like, resource-rich the areas were. So, I don't know. I'm speculating here. We shall find out. But I know I'm going to be set on compound for a little bit, though. That's not a bad problem to have. Problem. It's not a problem at all. Alright, I think I've exhausted that. Nope. Oh, there's even more down there. Okay. I don't want to fall down, though. Oh, it just keeps going. I may have put myself in a predicament. I'm gonna get myself in trouble if I keep this up. Okay. Yes, this is not a good situation to be in. Okay. Let's see if I can at least work my way out of this hole. Okay, cool. Almost. There we go. Let's pull some of this power in. That'll help. I'm trying to get exactly a full block. Don't need organics right now. Not a problem. You know, I think I'm good on compound. There's a lot of compound that I'm pulling back to the base. I want to leave enough room, so if there's stuff over here. All right, let's go check out this, and I may need to leave a beacon down and come back, but yeah, let's be very careful. What I'm trying to say, let's leave enough room and be careful not to fill up our storage in case there's anything good over here. Which there might be. There might not be, but there might be. I see some research. That's what I'm here for. What is that? Oh, that's the bottom of this thing. That's crazy looking. This is the biggest one I've come across yet. Okay, is there anything else? Well, there's a seat and some materials. Copper. Titanium. I don't really need the seat. Is there any more research? Possibly. What is up? Hmm. Don't see any there, but there is more stuff over here. I think that might be research. Not that. This. And indeed it is. Sweet. I feel like maybe... when I go back to the base, I should make a couple more of these storage things, because it seems like I'm picking up more materials than I am research. And that's fine. Perfectly fine. I don't need organic stuff right now. I mean, I hate wasting stuff, but... I mean, there's plant life everywhere. All right. Yeah, okay. You know, there are some things over here. Like, I think I can dig under these guys and get stuff. So, let's make a beacon if I can. And just put it down here to kind of just note that I've been here. And I'll carry one, at least one beacon with me from now on, so that way when I go out, I can say, hey, I've been here. Alright, well, I think I have a full truckload. I do. We are gonna head back home. I'm thinking home is through there. Okay, so that's kind of bad. I'm gonna have to pay more attention. I thought that I could always see my home tab. I don't think there's a map in the game just yet, if there is ever going to be one. There really should be. Careful. Oh, this is gonna end badly. How are we doing? We're doing good. We're doing good. There we go. Yep. Okay. Now, there was a hole over here. Is that it? Yes. Okay. We are good. Now, something I tend to do with games like this, the resource management type games, I tend to like to kind of, I guess, hoard stuff. Like, I like to build up a lot of resources, so that way when it comes time to actually building things and adding on to bases or building up whatever you're doing, I have the resources there in handy. So that's kind of what I've been doing. And I will probably continue a little bit further. I just, when it comes time to find all these new and cool things, all these new, you know, technologies or whatever, I want to be able to build them then and there and have fun with them. I don't want to have to go out and scrounge for more stuff. And if I do, you know, I want it to be a kind of a simple process. Okay, there we go. That is disorganized as crap. Okay. But it's fine. It is perfectly fine. What's not fine is the fact that I don't have any more of these storage things. Okay. Let's do it. Oh, I thought I had... Take that. Literally. So that way you can do your job. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4 of these guys. Okay. One. Question is, can I recycle one of these? I hear wind. Oh. Oh. Is it coming this way? It looks like it might be, and I really hope that my truck will be okay out here. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Come on. Alright, safe. Oh man, these things are so intense. I can't see my truck anymore. Oh no, I can barely see my truck over there. Hopefully it survives. Oh man. And yeah, my wind vane is not doing anything. I'm gonna have to look into that. I figured if anything right now is when it would be doing something. Alright guys, I think that that's going to do it for this episode. I'm going to weather out the storm, and then once it clears up, I'm going to get back into it and see what I can do about organizing my stuff, and then take the truck back out for another run for whatever I can find. So anyway guys, hope you're enjoying this. I know I am. As always, thanks for watching. Take care.